Welcome to the RaceGrooves Weekend Show. Glad that you made it. By the way, my wife, she's made it back home. Went to the airport over there, LAX, which is right next to Mattel's El Segundo headquarters. And not only do they have the big corporate structure, but they also have the Mattel toy store there. So for the Off the Pegs channel, you're going to be seeing an Off the Pegs video of the Mattel toy store coming up during the week. Actually, Sunday. You're probably watching this on Sunday or Saturday night, depending where you are. Anyways, not this channel. It's over on the Off the Pegs channel. I'm not sure which thumbnail I'm going to use. I haven't decided if I'm going to use the entrance where it actually says Mattel Toy Store, or am I going to show the picture of their shuttle bus where they shuttle people back and forth to their design center. I don't know. Which pic do you think I should use? Well, we're doing pretty good here in Southern California. Texas, Louisiana, Florida, yep, all the big storms are coming through there. I hope you all are safe. Hope your collection is dry. And that's a big issue with collectibles. Moisture, no good, unless you collect RC boats or something like that. Yeah, that'd be all right. Paul Miller, let's take some comments from the Off the Pegs channel. Paul Miller on my Jada toys. I got the second batch of the JDM cars. Paul Miller commented that the Honda NSX is the only one that he has found, and this set is awesome. Yeah, all the cars, great paint job. I'm not sure if I'm going to actually be reviewing them, but I showed them on the Off the Pick channel if you'd like to subscribe over there. Monster Jam Sam, I did a couple Monster Jam videos. But this one here, the Silver Collection showed up. Silver Collection, the second batch. And he wanted to know, hey, can you tell me why my stores don't stole? I think he meant stock. Don't stock. I live in Florida. I can't tell you why your stores don't stock in Florida. But to be honest with you, even though you see a new video from me every day on the Off the Pegs channel, right? I have a hard time finding video of something that I can present every day. Right now, I'm 5 days ahead. I have some stuff scheduled to, I think, Tuesday or Wednesday. But when I go to pick up my son, I might hit Walmart, Target, or I'll go a different way and I can hit, different stores like grocery stores, Walgreens. Sometimes they get stuff too. Big Lots, all sorts of different stores. So I try to take different paths and take... It's hard for me to find new stuff every week. So just because you see stuff new every day on my channel, it's not like there's a whole bunch of new stuff all the time. Besides, right now we're in September, right? Early September. Very, very soon, I would expect to see a flood of products for the Christmas holidays. Maybe that's what they're focusing on right now. Just kind of waiting until the new stuff comes in, and that's what it'll be. I'm pretty much in the same boat as you. Craco commented he just went to two different Walmarts yesterday and neither of them had any Monster Jam trucks at all, not one. The bad part about that is he can't even find out when the next delivery is. Not even one employee could tell me. They are really bad. Thank you for the video. But to be honest, you know, employees are just stalkers. They don't necessarily know when stuff's coming and going, right? Depending on the retailer, even if something's on the manifest that is going to show up at the store, doesn't necessarily mean that, you know, it's going to arrive. Most of the time, stalkers don't even know. And even if they tell you, they don't know. Mr. Dan and Harry, I love how kids can press delivery to release the car when they're ready. I might have to track this down for the exclusive Muscle Zone. Yeah, it was nice to be able to review the Hot Wheels Serpent's Revenge track set. Came with an exclusive Muscle Zone. Now, when I bought that track set, I bought the track set for the parts because I was doing birthday parties for kids. I can use the curves and I can use different parts for the parties, right? Well, the exclusive Muscle Tone, I didn't necessarily need the Muscle Tone. Not only did I get those sets at a nice price for the parts, right? The Muscle Tone, I was selling the Muscle Tone on the side. I don't remember, $5, $8. I honestly don't remember. I don't sell anything nowadays, but back then, that's how I reduced my costs, right? Sell the extra cars I didn't need. Came with 5 cars, Muscle Tone. Go ahead and sell it. I kept a couple. I actually still have 4 sealed box sets. Even though I opened one for the video, I still have 3 or 4 box sets I haven't opened. And I have boxes and boxes of parts where I opened it and I kept it. So expect to see that for a track time presentation. I think I'm going to call it the snake pit. I have a bunch of snakes. It's going to be a fun video. Hopefully you enjoy it. Hopefully it does well. Now, Carson Gold, he commented. Did he do a review? No, it was somebody else. He said that when he had got this set, the Vendetta had 5-spoke wheels, and he still has it. Freezing Candle commented, I remember this set. I could never get the snake to work properly. I remember that. I remember 10 years ago, and that's one reason probably why I never use the set at my parties, setting it up like a set, is because of how complicated it would be. If you were to just put the snake in like this on the post, he's kind of flat, right? And so he would go into the track. Instead of going over the curve, the head would spin and the tail would hit the curve, right? You got to set it in like this. And then it has a little ridge right here that it would ride on a rail. Yeah, I don't even know if I knew that 10 years ago. It wasn't until I did the review that it's like, why is this happening? And then I really looked at it and figured it out. So, yeah, I think a lot of people couldn't figure out how to get it to work properly either. Julie B, I know what set has a similar pieces, which is Raptor Blast. The booster has a rod, goes to this, spins this feature. And it's like, I don't remember any other sets. Boom, there you go, Julie B. Thank you very much. Raptor Blast. I'll be reviewing that one as well. And the Enchanted Sword YT, the Golden Sword YT. Cool vid. Make more like this video. Yeah, you'll be seeing more track set reviews, especially since I'll be getting some track stuff done because of the epic track battles. Get the reviews done, then use those tracks for the epic track battles. You knew about the epic track battles channel, didn't you? I hope so. Robbie Guariano, do you have any large old track sets like Slime Kano or T-Rex Takedown that you can review? I do have those, but I'm going to have to wait until next year for those because, like I just said, I need to do things that I can use for epic track battles. I'm not sure. I don't have I have parts to T-Rex. I don't know if I have. I don't have a sealed box, I don't believe. But as Slime Kano, I have a sealed set. That'll be reviewed next year. Elijah Roman, can Hot Wheels cars fit in this truck? Truckin' Tuesday. I did a Disneyland truck, Mickey Mouse truck, and it had Disney racers on it. Let me show you some pictures where Hot Wheels compared to some various Disney racers, and you can tell how they're comparable in size. The Real Cobra Burnout. I love that you unbox and open these. I wish they all fit, but still a fun truck to get it at your Disneyland. I botched that. Anyways, yeah, the car that comes with it doesn't even fit. That's the way it goes. It fits on the platform, but when you try to get it out of the truck, it bumps. What else did I want to comment on? Yeah, I like unboxing them. What did I want to come on? Fun, yeah, you know what? Disneyland, it's a fun toy to get, right? As a gift, it's a fantastic gift. And the Gold Shot is going to Disneyland, a regular occurrence for you or your family. If so, it must be very fun and very expensive. Yeah, guess what? Amanda and Jeremy, my two kids, they have season passes. So they go as often. My daughter goes a lot more than my son. And now my daughter's boyfriend, he works for Disneyland. So he can get people in for free. So I got to go for free. We went down there. And I wanted to go on the new, it's not Tower of Terror now. Now they have it as the Guardians something or other. So I wanted to go on the new experience, check that out. So he let me get in for free, rode that, did a couple rides. But I really wanted to go down there because I wanted to get some Disney cars. And since they're annual pass members, 20% off. So that truck was $25, 20% off. That's like $5 off. Yeah, Disneyland is not cheap. Even with the discounts, it's not cheap. My wife, hey, you want to get some season passes? Well, when I go, I work 7 days a week. When will we go? She's in Kentucky 5 days a week, right? When will we go? I'm on the weekend, working on weekend shows. Oh, well, when are we going to go? So once in a while, I might go with my daughter and her boyfriend. He'll get me in, but... yeah, too busy to go. Tiger McCabe. They made the Mickey Mouse hauler for the Disney Racers line before. They just changed the logo to Disney Racers on the truck, and on the back of the trailer, the old logo was M for Mickey Mouse. Hey, thanks for letting me know that there was a previous release. I happened to check eBay. I was just curious. I did find a sample to where it was a Disney Racers truck, but I guess you're saying that it's there's a sample even older than this. Actually, I see it. Look on the hood. You can see the M for Mickey Mouse. I'm pretty sure that I had a Disney Racers sticker on mine. Hey, wait a second. They got three cars in that. So how come they got three cars before and I only got one car? Oh, never mind. Looks like that just was a cardboard insert and it wasn't three cars. So maybe the one I got was better. At least I got a car to go with the truck. Okay, I'm going to take a break and I'm going to take some Ask RaceGrooves questions coming up next. Here we go. A Spot Reviews, Gaming, and More. Ask RaceGrooves, what's your favorite track time? I'm not sure about my favorite, but a definite moment that was fun to recall. There's been a couple. One, that tank truck destroyed the track as he was coming down the hill. I don't know. I don't remember which one that was. But one that's always a fond memory is 2014 K. That's when I used, I think, Let's Go. And I actually had a figure with Let's Go, send him down the track. And the figure got decapitated because I had something, a low bridge. So that's a favorite time. I have a link down below. And if I remember, I'll put a link up above as well. By the way, on that note, I had asked a while ago, I still would like to make like a track time retrospective. Let's say favorite moments of 2014 track time videos. So I have a playlist in the description of the 2014 track time videos. And if you see a favorite moment, comment on that video. And I make my compilation, I'll be looking for comments to include with a 2014 compilation video that's going to like highlight favorite moments of each track time video. So if you like shout outs, it's a good chance for you to get a shout out when I get to that video. Like I don't have enough stuff to do. What else do we have here? We have Dylan Sagales Carrillo, RaceGrooves, Ask RaceGrooves. The car Bassline is great. It's similar to the car Solid Muscle. Watch it for the next week and show. Sometimes I can do it, sometimes I can't, but you're gonna, guess what? You got picked. I love the weekend show. Thank you very much. Good job. Great day. Bye. So I did take some pictures of Bassline right next to Solid Muscle. I picked a blue sample of Bassline so that it would be comparable in color so that the lighting would be similar. I can see how the overall side angle of the car looks the same, but when I look at other things are not the same, not similar. Spoilers are different. Bassline had speakers in the back. Solid Muscle has some tanks, maybe with nitrous fuel. Looking at the windows and grills, not very similar. Look at the driver's compartment. There's definitely a different angle for the back of the cab. Not similar. So there's some slight similarities, but I don't think there's a bunch. But it's up to you. Fail Man, Ask RaceGrooves, what time is it when you post your weekend shows? Every time it's at 11 p.m. or 12 a.m. in Brazil. Yeah, you know, the last few weeks, I kind of published it maybe 8:30, kind of later in the evening. And depending on where you are time zone-wise, you know, it just depends. I publish anytime between Friday night and Sunday night here in California. It just depends on when I get the shows done. Right now, I'm filming on the weekends, so I try to publish on like Saturday night or Sunday morning. Sometimes it's as late as Sunday night. It's just the way it goes. Especially if I want to include comments from the week, I kind of have to wait. I can't work on too much ahead of time. I can't snip some comments from like earlier comments. But yeah, I have been that. It can go anytime. Robert Flores, Ask RaceGrooves, how do I send fan mail in? I have a gift for you. I also ordered a Tomica set. I'll tell you how it goes. And he said, oh my God, I need these. Next time I see them, P.S. I love your channel. I didn't write down. Oh, he must have posted that in the. I'm not sure where he posted that, to be honest with you. Anyways, the link for fan mail is in the description. So it should be in almost every description for many months now, including the one you commented on. Sakar Sial, Ask RaceGrooves, hey, I was wondering how the Back to the Future DeLorean would go in this track. He posted that on the, I believe, Serpent's Revenge. Of Fortunately, I have Serpent's Revenge taken down. I'm already working on the next track set. Here's a little sneak peek if you'd just for you guys tuning in. Nasnina Ahmed, hey, can I get one of your exact same models for a reasonable price? Posted that on my Bugatti Veyron video. And of course, when people say reasonable price, what they mean is a price they want to pay. Well, you know what? If something's selling for $15, I'm going to ask for $15. I don't sell. But whenever you say reasonable price, it's like, for me, I just tune you out because you're not being reasonable. Your reasonable is not what. Why should I sell? If something's worth $15, selling for $15, why should I sell it for like $5? Why should I give away $10 of value? $10, I could buy lunch or maybe half a lunch, depending on how hungry I am. Pokemon guy. Wow, you're pretty old. August 24th, 1948. Wow, 52, 62. You're older than me. RaceGrooves, do you still buy hot cases? And is the owner trustworthy? Yeah, you know what, Kurt, the former guy who owned hot cases are the plastic tubs that we keep our carted Hot Wheels in. You can search hot cases, plastic containers, and you should be able to find them. Or Hot Wheels hot cases, you should find them. So the previous guy sold his tooling to Kurt, and Kurt's trustworthy, right? And do I still buy them? When I go to the convention, Kurt's at the convention, and I'll pick them up there because I got my Chevy Avalanche. I don't have to pay shipping, right? I just pick them up there, fill up the Avalanche, bring them home. Yeah, he's very trustworthy. If Kurt still owns it. As far as I know, Kurt still owns it. Cars are life. RaceGrooves, are Hot Wheels Elite Models cars any good? Yeah, they were high quality, over $100 Hot Wheels. Large scale, lots of parts, lots of details. And are they any good? I didn't buy any. A little too much money. If I'm going to spend that kind of money, I'm probably going to get a different brand just for a different experience. I buy enough Hot Wheels. They never offered to send me one to review, so I'm not spending the money for the review. Hello, 360 Jelly Jr. I like watching these vids in my free time. Really cheers me up after a bad day like today. That was from the last weekend show. I'm glad you guys are enjoying this conversational style that the weekend show has kind of changed to at the time. It's kind of time considerations. It was taking me 2 days to make it before. Some people like this, some people didn't. Right now, this is going to be the format. Sorry you had a bad day. We all have bad days. So I'm glad that you were able to recover. And this made you have a better day. Let you forget about what was troubling you. I love video games. I like your Goomba hat. Yeah, I don't know where I got this Goomba hat. I don't remember if I bought it. Oh, yeah, by the way, I told the barber, give me a little taper on the side. Look what they did. Look at the light. Can't even see. Taper? That's nearly bald. What are you doing, Bubba? And then I wear this one because it's darker and because the lighting looks better with the darker hat. Luis gave me this one, but it's the golf hat. These are the two that I keep handy. I'll go ahead and wear the golf hat. Go ahead and wear it. But anyways, where did I get? I'm glad you like the hat. I like Nintendo, Mario, video games. Don't get to play too much lately. I got another question coming up similar. But anyways, I'm not sure where I got the hat. Don't remember. I asked Jeremy, hey, did you guys give this to me for Christmas? And he's like, no. I don't know where it came from. Matthew Mund, hi, RaceGrooves. I just got into Hot Wheels, and one of my favorite Hot Wheels models is HW Formula Solar. Very nice. Fast car, all skinny wheels. Thank you for sharing your favorite Hot Wheel. Minecraft Gamer, you said that you started YouTube in 2009. In one of your videos, you said 2008. Is that how he said it? Oh, look at it. It says, keep calm and game on for his little image there. He probably didn't say it that way. Minecraft Gamer, you said that you started YouTube in 2009. In one of your videos, you said 2008. Well, it just depends on, I just memorized 2009. Because before then, I just did a few videos. But 2009 is when I kind of really started doing reviews and trying to create packages. Presentations, right? Instead of just goofing around, let's go ahead and take a look at some of those videos from the first few years, just so you know what I'm talking about. By the way, in the description, you can find a link to my first 10 videos playlist. Now, you can see there, Hot Wheels Ice Sculpture in 2003. Well, that's not, I recorded that in 2003. But YouTube, you know, I signed up in 2006. So that was my first video. And I just happen to have that video file. As you can see, I put up, let's see, that's 2006. One, two, I put three videos up in 2006. And when you're talking about, you know, hopping my channel, is it Hot Wheels? Well, guess what? That second video, that wasn't even my car. It was a $10,000 Dior auction. They put special lights on it. But look, my third video, Johnny Lightning American Glory Tea Bucket. It was a white lightning. Took it right out of the package. And then a Hot Wheels Sizzlers Power Pit, 2007. That might have been the only video I did in 2007. 2008, yeah, see, this was the silly stuff that we did on YouTube back then. Faking like you're pulling your fingernail. I didn't. They're still there if you want to see them. And here's why I count 2009 is because, look, I reviewed the starter set. I reviewed a trick track set. I reviewed another trick track set, Mega Chomp. And look, they were doing very well. Look, 600,000 views, 700,000 views. They did very well. And that's kind of what, that's why I say 2009 is when I really decided I was going to start focusing on making videos on YouTube. But I didn't make that many videos in 2009. Look at 2010 even. I started making more presentations. Now that I look at this, this might even be a better starting point. Because look, August 15th, August 18th, August 19th, and 2010. So while 2009 is when I did make a few reviews on some sets, who knows, maybe we can even count 2010 as when August of 2010 is when I really started to decide, let's make some videos. Because after that point in August, I was making like a video every other day, every 2 or 3 days. I didn't think that people had the time, and I didn't want to do too much content more than people could watch, right? Now you jump to 2017, it's a totally different story, right? So much content out there, and it wasn't long after that that I started making, I did a video every day for a year and a half. And it's like, and I had a full-time job with the post office. I got 2009 memorized because that's when I did those three sets. I'm still going to say that's when I started. But 2010 is when I really aggressively decided I'm going to start making lots of videos. As far as that goes, off the pegs. I'm challenging myself to have a video every day again. It's kind of fun. It's like starting all over. Penguin Duck 820, Ask RaceGrooves, what's happening to the Speed Machines episode? I've never heard of that car line and excited for the video about it. Speed Machines. Part of the mess, I was sorting some cars, so I was hiding the tubs. You can't see it. But yeah, Speed Machines. I had mentioned when I did my Lamborghini video that I was going to do a Speed Machines video. I'll be getting to that, but I got to get some track things done. You'll be noticing me focused on tracks right now because I got to get Epic Track Battles going. So it'll be coming, Speed Machines video. Don't know when. Now, here we have a Russian gentleman with a channel, pretty good channel. He just passed 100,000 views. Good afternoon. How did you get 500,000 subscribers? What's the secret of your success? Thank you. Can't tell you. If I tell you, it's not a secret no more. But just like we were talking about 2009, 2010, I've been at this for a while, right? And not only that, I was doing birthday parties for kids, right? So I have a forte for communicating, right? Just put it that way. Just have a forte for communicating with kids, right? Or creating a conversation in the video. I don't sit here high and mighty because I'm a popular YouTuber or I'm a famous collector, you know. No, I'm just a regular collector like everybody else. But I work hard to make my videos. And look, it took a long time for me to get to 500,000 subscribers. I didn't look to see how long you've been doing it to get to 100,000. But hopefully on one of my other channels, I'll get 100,000. You know what? I was supposed to show. I can't show it today. I still haven't shown my silver play button. I meant to show it. Sitting right there. Hopefully next week I'll remember to get to the silver play button to show it for RaceGrooves. But it'd be nice to get a silver play button for Epic Track Battles, for Off the Pigs. Still like making videos. Still want to grow. Still want to have fun. I wish you luck on your channel. No secret. Just work. Takes a lot of work, a lot of time. Some people are lucky. There's some luck to it. Don't get me wrong. Okay. There is some luck to it. But it's also about making content that people want to see. Sometimes it's not necessarily what you want to do. Sometimes it's what people want to see. What can I say? Ryan Productions, I am less than 3U race crews. Oh, he hearts me. Thank you. Thank you very much. By the way, do you know Forza? I never heard of him. Is he in California? What's his last name? Forza, the video game. Yeah, we have Forza. I don't get to play too much because, like I said, I work too much. But, yeah, I have the Forza 3, I think. I have one version of Horizon, and I can't tell you which ones. I got them. The one with the Ford GT, I got that one too. And Super Saiyan 3985. What ticks me off is how you barely showed them from the back. Backdraft is definitely my favorite from the WR. That'd be the World Race. He commented on my World Race videos. And in going back and looking at the years 2009, 2010, 2011. Yeah, you know what? 2010, I started making like a video every 2 or 3 days. Did I say 2010? Anyways, at a certain point, you know, I was going to show the Highway 35 World Race cars and then the Acceleracers cars. But I made them instead of doing, it's too much for one video, I broke them into teams and showed this team on Monday, then Tuesday, Wednesday, 4 different teams, or however many. And then Acceleracers showed the teams and spread them out different days, right? Because I thought it was too much for one video. And that was part of the time of me just growing the channel, coming up with entertaining and informational information videos. Maybe it's time for me to make another Highway 35 World Race video just showing the cars, because I've shown them from time to time in other videos, but not to where they get their own feature video. Hey, Super Saiyan, maybe it's time for me to make another video, but on those cars feature video, but I'll be working on track related and place related videos probably for the rest of the year. I think I do need to get back to that. Anyways, thank you for tuning in to another RaceGrooves weekend show. I hope your family's safe and sound. Thanks for watching. Happy collecting. Bye-bye.